Hi students, this is your Prabhu sir. In this section we are going to discuss about excellent tricks to know the types of simple epithelial tissues. It's a complicated topic in 11th standard. More questions is come from the NEET exam as well as the board exam. See that it come under the 11th standard chapter 7, structural organization in animal, come under the various epithelial tissues. Squamous, cuboidal, and columnar, ciliated, and glandular epithelial tissue. In a simple way, how to remember? So easy to recall and easy to understand the concept. Any questions after complete this video section, you can attend any type of question if they ask in the NEET exam. First, let us go to that. What is epithelial tissue? Generally, tissues are four types: epithelial tissue, connective tissue, muscular tissue and neural tissue. There are four types. Among that, epithelial tissue, which is present above. The meaning of epi means above or outer. Usually the tissue have a two surface. Now one surface of the epithelial tissue, either it's face outside environment. Suppose our skin is epithelial tissue, it face outside the environment, or else it face the body fluid. For example, the epithelial tissue which is present inside the blood vessels, this epithelial tissue faces the body fluid such as blood. So the location of the epithelial tissue, either outer covering, otherwise lining of some body parts such as blood vessels. Here the cells are compactly packed with little intercellular matrix. The cells are compactly packed means, see, this is one cell, this is another cell, so another cell. So one cell to another cell compactly packed with this little space, little matrix or intercellular space. There are two types of epithelial tissue: simple epithelial tissue, compound epithelial tissue. In the case of simple epithelial tissues, the cells are arranged in a single layer. Laterally it is arranged, either right side or left side, not one above another. That is called simple epithelial tissue. So it is present lining of the body cavity, or lining of the duct, or lining of the tubules. The best example, as I said already, within the blood vessels. That's the lining of the tubules. Blood vessel is a tube. The compound epithelial tissues have several layers, one above the another. It arranged one above the another. So it is a protective in function, which is present on the skin. For example, our skin have many layers of epithelial tissues. Now, the much more important part, the tricks to know the various type of simple epithelial tissue. Generally, the simple epithelial tissues are three types. One is squamous epithelium, then another one is cuboidal epithelium, then columnar epithelium. You see later, this one we can discuss, right? In the case of the simple epithelium, the squamous epithelium, in the case of squamous epithelium, I will show that clearly. Only in each epithelium, only 6 points we are going to discuss now. The first point, it's a common point in all the three types. If you read in a table manner, in such a way, if you read the table manner by comparative manner, you can understand easily. This is an easy way to understand the concept. See, first, let us discuss about the epithelial tissues, squamous epithelial tissue. It's a single layer. It comes under the simple epithelial tissue. So all the three types are single layer cells only. And the shape means thin, flattened, irregular type cell. Thin, flattened cell and irregular. In the case of cuboidal. See, in the case of cuboidal also single layer cells. In the case of columnar also single layer. Everything single layer arrangement. That means it arranged laterally, either right side or left side, not one above another. That is called a simple epithelium. and with the little intercellular spaces. Just now we have discussed. Now, the shape, second point related to, this is point number one, point number two. Second point related to the shape. The shape is very thin, flat and irregular. Thin, flat and irregular. Here cuboidal, cube shaped. Columnar, tall and slender shape. Tall and slender shape. Like a pillar. It is generally called pillar shaped cells. Third point, where it is found in our body. The squamous epithelium found in the blood vessels and air sac of the lungs. Blood vessels are air sac of the lungs. The cuboidal epithelium found in the gland, endocrine gland, exocrine gland, salivary gland, pituitary gland, in that it is present. And the cuboidal epithelial tissues found in nephron of the kidney, nephron tubule of the kidney. Columnar epithelial tissue found in the stomach, inner lining of stomach and intestine. So this is blood vessels, air sacs, gland, nephron and columnar epithelial present in the stomach and intestine. This function. So if you understand this one, it is easy for you. For example, just it is squamous epithelium present in the blood vessel and the air sacs. So I have drawn the blood vessels here. See, this is the one blood vessels. Especially the thin blood vessels. Inside the blood vessels, the blood travels. Thin blood vessels end with the cells. So within the thin blood vessel, the wall made up of squamous epithelial tissues, right? So this squamous epithelial tissue diffuse the oxygen from blood to cell, and from cell to blood it diffuse the carbon dioxide. So this wall of the blood vessels act as a diffusion boundary. Here in the air sac. See, this is alveoli. Within the alveoli is a air sac in the lungs. Within the alveoli, air present. They are having oxygen. It end with the near to the blood vessels. Inside the blood vessel, blood sac. So that air sac wall made up of squamous epithelial tissues. So here also the same thing. The squamous epithelium act as a diffusion boundary. So from the alveoli, oxygen enter into blood, diffuse into blood. From the blood, the carbon dioxide diffuse into alveoli. So it act as a, in the case of squamous epithelium function, the squamous epithelium act as a diffusion boundary. This is a fourth point. Here in the gland, for example, salivary gland. And in the nephron, they have drawn the salivary gland here. See, this is the gland, salivary gland, which is present inside the our mouth. This is a gland part. This is a duct part. It's a duct. This is the gland part. This gland stored some quantity of this secretion, and it release the secretion into the duct. This gland part contains cuboidal epithelium and the nephron. Nephron, the short diagram I will draw. This is a Bowman capsule, and this is a cluster of afferent arterioles. This is PCT, proximal convoluted tubules. This is a Bowman capsule. And this is Henle's loop, and this one DCT, distal convoluted tubule, and this is the collecting duct. Now, inside the lining of the nephron, which is present inside the kidney. Nephron is a structural functional unit of kidney. This and all made up of cuboidal epithelial tissue. Now, what is the function? That's the location. Here, in the glandular part, it responsible for secretory function. It secretes the saliva. Sweat gland secretes the sweat. Here, in the nephron part of the cuboidal epithelium, responsible for absorption. Whenever the blood enter here, within the blood, the nitrogenous waste material and all absorbed, right? So the cuboidal epithelial tissue, the main function of the cuboidal epithelial tissues, secretion and absorption. In the columnar epithelial tissues, same thing, secretion and absorption. Because as we discussed, it is present in the stomach and intestine. Inside the stomach, I have drawn the stomach here. See, this is a stomach. Within the stomach, some HCl, pepsin, renin, these are all the enzymes and all secrete. So inside the stomach, inner wall of the stomach, having columnar epithelial tissue, it responsible for secretory function. And this is small intestine. The small intestine continues as a large intestine. Inside the intestine, it acts as a absorptive function. Here secretion, here absorption. So both cuboidal epithelium, columnar epithelium, fourth point function, secretion, absorption. Here also secretion, absorption. Fifth point, which is related to microvilli. Microvilli means small hair-like structure. The microvilli not present in the squamous epithelium. It is present in the cuboidal epithelium, but only in the PCT, proximal convoluted tubule. See, this is the nephron. This is PCT, proximal convoluted tubule. This is DCT, distal convoluted tubule. Only here inside the microvilli, I mean cilia, are present. See, microvilli means, suppose this is a cell, cuboidal cell, on the surface, one hair-like structure will be present. That is microvilli. Here in the columnar epithelial cell, the free surface have a microvilli, especially which is present in the intestine. In the intestine. About last sixth point, nuclei present in the generally center part of the squamous epithelium. In the center part of the squamous epithelium, nucleus present, nuclei. In the case of cuboidal epithelium, cuboidal epithelium, the nuclei present here also in the center. But in the case of columnar epithelium, the nuclei present at the base is much more important. That's all about the simple way. So if you compare it and read, it is easy for you to understand the concept. It is based on the presence of microvilli. This microvilli present in cuboidal epithelium as well as columnar epithelium. So one more type is present in the epithelial tissue, that is called ciliated epithelium. This is termed as ciliated epithelium. It is visible now. Ciliated epithelium. In the case of ciliated epithelium, if the columnar cell or cuboidal cell has cilia, that is called ciliated epithelium. It is present in the bronchi as well as fallopian tube. Bronchi means, this is a trachea. Trachea divided into two parts, right bronchi, left bronchi. Each bronchi enter into lungs. Within the bronchi, the cilia is present. Fallopian tube is the female reproductive organ. Just I'll draw the female reproductive organ. It's a rough diagram. This is uterus. This is vagina. And this one, fallopian tube. Here, ovary is present, a pair of ovary. It releases the egg during ovulation. It enters into fallopian tube. So inside the fallopian tube, inner lining of the fallopian tubes have a cilia, because it is made up of ciliated columnar epithelial tissue. Okay, what is the function? No? The function of the ciliated columnar epithelial tissue, movement of particles, especially gamete or mucus in the specific direction. Gamete means here, Egg is a gamete. The gamete enter inside the fallopian tube and it reach the uterus. This is movement of gamete. In the case of bronchi, the mucus does not allow to enter into the lungs. The lungs filled with only air. So mucus should go outside in such a way the cilia move only unidirections. Based on the presence of secretion, secrete something, the cuboidal epithelium and the columnar epithelium secretory in function. So based on that secretion, one more type of epithelial tissues are there, that is called glandular epithelium. Some columnar epithelium, cuboidal epithelium have a specialized for secretion is called glandular epithelium. It is four types, based on the number of cell. The glandular epithelium are two types, unicellular glandular epithelium, multicellular glandular epithelium. The unicellular means made up of one cell. So isolated glandular cells is a unicellular glandular epithelium. Here multicellular glandular epithelium is a cluster of glandular cells. Examples of unicellular glandular epithelium, globular cells in the alimentary canal. Examples of multicellular glandular epithelium, many examples are there. Examples, salivary gland, sweat gland, etc. And based on the secretion, secretory types, it's based on the secretory types, there are two type of gland, exocrine gland, endocrine gland. The exocrine gland secrete mainly enzymes and also mucus, saliva, air wax, milk, tears, sweat, etc. This exocrine gland are called duct gland, because it have one gland like structure and one tube like structure. This tube like structure is termed as duct. So it releases the content through the duct directly to the target place. Our salivary gland present below the tongue, but its secretion directly to the mouth. Our mouth is a target place. But in the case of endocrine gland, it secretes only hormones. It never secretes any other things like exocrine gland. Endocrine gland, otherwise called ductless gland, because it does not have a duct. It releases directly its secretion, its hormone to the body fluid. For examples, this is a gland, it does not have a duct, I said. So suppose this is one gland, it secretes the hormones inside the blood. Examples of endocrine gland, there are many endocrine glands are there, pituitary gland and thyroid gland, etc. Examples of exocrine gland, salivary gland, tears gland, sweat gland, liver, etc. Thank you.